Hey everyone, how's it going today? I just want to talk to you about a product that I stumbled upon by Rust-Oleum for frosted windows. I recently used it on real windows and experimented on model buildings, and it seemed to work quite well. Not sure if anyone out there is already using this idea. This is something that I just kind of came across and thought it'd be worth sharing with everyone that may not know about it and is looking to, for something to do with their model buildings, so the buildings don't have that hollow look inside them. I noticed, when you don't do anything with the windows, especially if it's a building that's got a lot of windows and you're doing a night scene, you could see right into those buildings, possibly see the light bulbs. And the building, it just kind of takes away from the overall building and the realism. The building just looks hollow and it just looks like an empty, the building just looks like a shell. So what I wanted to show you is how you go from windows like this, where you can see through them, to using this frosted window paint, if you will, and you end up getting frosted windows like this, okay? And what this is going to do is it's going to allow light to pass through the window, but you're not going to be able to see into the building and be able to see that there's really nothing in there, except for maybe some wires and a light. Whatever the case may be. So this is something, that I think will help a lot of people. And I know some people take the time to do a full interior, or maybe they, have paper cutouts that they put in the windows, like to represent mini blinds or shades, those sort of things. The people that do the full interiors really amaze me. Those buildings look phenomenal when they finish them. However, I'm more into the model railroad operations, and I'm not interested in really putting a lot of time and that much detail into a building to where I'm actually doing the inside. I do like to get my buildings to where they look, realistic on the outside, but I'm not looking to do anything too much on the inside. So what I'm going to do is we're going to show you some of the steps and the product that I use to accomplish this. So just check it out. All right, and there's a close-up of the product. It's by Rust-Oleum, and it's for to make create frosted glass, semi-transparent finish. The only place that I've found this so far is at AC Moore. None of the hardware stores or anywhere that I've seen that sells Rust-Oleum seem to have this. So check your local craft store if you're looking for this product. Okay, so the building I'm actually doing this to is the Milwaukee style train station and the shed by Walters. The shed's already completed and built. I'll show you that a little bit later. And now you're gonna see the actual pieces that I have here that I've already done quite a bit of work to. Here's all the roof sections here. They were originally gray, this color gray here, and I painted them green. And as you can see on the wall pieces, the wall sections, the gray, the green, that's all hand painted on there. And the walls are actually painted a totally different color than what was there in the box. Okay, and as you can see, most of these walls are pretty much complete, with the exception of this window frosting that we're gonna do here today. Alright. And I do want to say that this has been a very rewarding building to construct. A lot of pieces to it. It's taken me quite some time to get it to where it is now. And here on these spurs here, that gives you an idea what the original color and what the original pieces looked like before any kind of painting was done to them. I used a red color to spray the walls. Okay, and then what I did is I used a white shoe polish and went over all the wall pieces and let that shoe polish get into all the brickwork. And then I just wiped it off the top of the surface, and what remained is the white down in all the little spaces between the bricks. And it kind of gives a little bit of like that aged look to it. Here's the train shed that's already been constructed. Pretty much the only thing left to do to this is going to be to actually set up the tracks that go through there. This shed is big enough, wide enough for 6 tracks to go through. And when this is on the layout, it's going to have 2 main lines go through. It's going to have 2 holding tracks go through for passenger trains. And then it's going to have a yard lead that goes to the main yard that's going to be on the layout. And then the last track is going to be going to the short line railroad on the layout. And everything's just going to kind of branch off from the station here. So there's the train shed. Okay, this step is really easy. Do it in a well-ventilated area. I prefer to do it outside. All you're going to do is you're just going to hold the can about 10 to 12 inches away from the window panes on the back of the walls, and you're just going to give it a nice even spray going across. Alright, and then that should be it. And then what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take these indoors and I'm going to let that dry up for about 5 or 10 minutes, and then I'll show you the finished product. Okay, so that's how you frost the windows in your model buildings. You go from a hollow shell to frost the windows that you can't see through. Hopefully this was helpful to some of you out there. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. If you want to keep up on the videos that I post on model trains and real railroads, don't forget to subscribe to the BMAC channel. Thanks.